My name is Dr. Sharif and I'm a family physician that specializes in women's health and fertility. Today I'll be talking to you about polycystic ovarian syndrome or PCOS. So what is PCOS? PCOS is essentially a hormone imbalance of male hormones or androgens in comparison to baseline. We also see many women have abnormal insulin activity as well. This is the most common hormone disorder that affect women of reproductive age. Specifically, 1 in 12 women are affected by this condition. The exact cause of PCOS actually remains controversial. So it's quite a complex condition. But one thing we do know is that it carries a strong genetic component. So you might know people in your family that are actually also affected by PCOS. One thing that's important to know is that lifestyle, such as weight, diet, and exercise, can carry a huge benefit in controlling your symptoms. So what are the symptoms of PCOS? PCOS actually has a very large spectrum in how symptoms can present in an individual. So you will never see the exact same symptoms in every individual that has PCOS. The general symptoms can range from menstrual irregularities or infrequent or absent periods. You can have abnormal hair growth of the face, chest, or back. You can also have acne. There's also infertility, obesity, and something called metabolic syndrome, which is a combination of conditions that include high blood pressure, high cholesterol, imbalance in your sugars or prediabetes, as well as abdominal obesity. Over the course of their life, women that have PCOS are at increased risk of developing type 2 diabetes, a precancerous finding of the uterine lining called endometrial hyperplasia, and potentially heart disease. The sad reality is that unfortunately, over 50% of women with PCOS don't actually get diagnosed or receive the treatment they need until much later in life, generally when they are struggling to get pregnant. When it comes to diagnosis, a very common myth is that you must have multiple cysts on your ovaries before you can be considered to have PCOS. There is actually no single lab test or imaging test that can diagnose you with PCOS right away. The actual conditions to diagnose PCOS is a criteria that's called the Rotterdam criteria, where you would have to meet two out of the three following conditions. You either have to have absent or infrequent menstrual cycles. We either have to be able to detect abnormal male hormones, generally made on a lab test, or we see polycystic ovaries on ultrasound. But before an official diagnosis of PCOS can be made, it is very important that you rule out any other possible causes, because there are many hormonal conditions that can mimic the features of PCOS. So how can diet and exercise affect PCOS? Well, we know that women with PCOS often struggle with elevated weight, and what comes with that includes increased insulin levels, insulin resistance, infrequent periods, and trouble ovulating regularly. The good news, though, is that diet and exercise is very responsive to PCOS, especially when it's aimed at controlling insulin resistance and ovulation issues that can lead to infertility problems. Studies have actually shown that losing as little as 2 to 5% of your body weight is enough to bring back your monthly periods and help you ovulate naturally. In addition, it can prevent type 2 diabetes from developing. Having said that though, it's important to know that women that are overweight aren't the only ones that are affected by PCOS. Women of all body types can be affected by this condition. Exercise and diet alone can help improve your symptoms naturally. However, sometimes lifestyle changes is not enough to help your symptoms, and in that situation, medications should be considered. There are a variety of medications that can be utilized to help control the symptom that affects you the most. So for women that have irregular periods, we typically prescribe the birth control pill or oral contraceptives to ensure that you're having regular monthly periods. In addition, it can also help with symptoms of acne or facial hair growth. Alternatively, if you're not interested in taking a daily pill, or if you're trying to conceive, we can use something called the progesterone-only pill, where you would take it every 4 to 6 weeks for about 10 days, and that will also help produce a regular period. For other symptoms, such as facial hair growth, there is a medication that's typically known to control blood pressure called spironolactone. One of the benefits is that it can minimize hair growth as well. But you should know that this is a medication for women that are not trying to get pregnant or are not pregnant, as it can have some detrimental effects to the fetus. When it comes to fertility, there are a variety of medications that we use. One common medication that you may have heard of is called metformin. This is a classic medication that's typically treating diabetes. But this medication helps to make your body more sensitive to insulin, and in turn, it can actually decrease insulin levels. And we know in PCOS, high insulin levels are also associated with high androgen levels, or the male hormone. So by decreasing the insulin levels, we are decreasing the androgen levels, and that makes your body more sensitive to ovulate, and therefore help you get pregnant. Other medications include Clomid and Letrozole. These are also medications that make your body more sensitive to stimulate ovulation and to help your eggs or follicles grow. So as you can see, there's a variety of medications that can be tapped into, but every person has an individual plan and it's only specific to you.